The first week of school, we generally have a parent open house, or where the parents come and follow their student's schedule from teacher to teacher, class to class. So the parents can just spend 10 minutes in each class learning what the teacher's all about. Having put three girls through high school now and gone to many parent open houses, it gets a little tedious when you walk in, they hand you a syllabus and talk about their rules. When my children are in high school, I don't need to know the rules, they do. So what I like to do for the parents is have a little fun. So Susie's mother is going to come up here and help me with this. And of course, I would make the parent wear goggles, because one of the things I do talk about in my classroom are safety issues. I do talk to the parents about these. And what I've come up with is that we have an analogy for our students' brain. Okay, it's a styrofoam cup. But into this brain throughout the year, we're going to be adding some information. In chemistry class, we're going to talk a lot about measurement and how to do proper lab procedures. We're going to talk a lot about forming hypotheses and testing them. We're going to move into studying the structure of the atom. We're going to do things with molecules and ions. And we're going to get into moles and that wonderful word, stoichiometry. We're going to talk about gases and solids and liquids. Oh, and your student's brain is going to get very full. Well, that would be fine because the brain is actually very large and can handle much more than we're giving them, but there's a problem. Actually, there are many problems. They're distractions. And the problem is the student isn't just concerned with chemistry class. There's English and French and all those other classes they have to take. That's a distraction. And of course, you know, Susie sits next to Billy. That's a distraction. Oh, and she has band practice after school. That takes up a lot of time. Susie's a swimmer. Do you know how much time students spend swimming? Susie's a good kid, though. She can handle all these distractions and keep the information. But sometimes students can't handle all of the distractions that we give them. Sometimes the distractions are too difficult for them to handle. And our job as parents is to be able to get them through those distractions. Like the party they want to go to on Saturday night, and you say, you know, I think you'd be better off staying at home. Or maybe their friends are taking an overnight camping trip. And you say, you know, that just doesn't make me feel very comfortable to have you go to that. But they still plead and they whine, and we give in sometimes because we have to trust them. And sometimes those distractions are just going to be too much for them to handle and keep on top of all their schoolwork. And so we find that all this information we've been so carefully putting into their brains all year, and actually they've been putting them into their brains. And all the distractions are going to cause them to forget some of the things that they've been learning. And it's going to start to leak out. And it's our job as teachers and parents to help them to keep what they need inside and to be able to handle their schoolwork and their being a teenager at the same time.